Good evening and welcome to the Buck Stops here. I'm Vishnu Shoman. On the program tonight, it's truly a great time for Indian cricket. Our women cricketers are the toast of the nation. Yes, it is true that we didn't win the World Cup. We lost by just a few runs yesterday. But it is clear now that finally Indian women's cricket has some of the star following that Indian men's cricket enjoys. And that's just wonderful. Stereotypes have been shattered as India celebrates finally of the successes of a group of these wonderful young sporting champions.
We जैसे बहुत सारे messages, calls और social media में बहुत सारा like हमारे बारे में बात हो रही है तो ये अच्छी बात है और इस चीज को हमने बहुत ही positive इसमें लिया है और अभी खुशी की बात ये है कि बहुत सारी लड़कियां women's cricket के लिए आएंगी खेलने के लिए और अभी इसमें हमारे लिए और हमारी टीम को और अच्छा बनाने के लिए हमारे लिए एक अच्छा मौका है अभी
हार के बुरा तो लगा ही है बिकॉज वर्ल्ड कप फाइनल है ऐसा बार बार नहीं होता है कि आप लोग फाइनल्स खेलो और हम सबके लिए मोस्ट ऑफ द प्लेयर्स के लिए फर्स्ट एक्सपीरियंस था कि हम लोग फाइनल्स खेल रहे हैं डेफिनेटली क्लोज गेम था तो सबको बुरा लग रहा था
यंग लड़कियों को मोटिवेट कर पाएंगे इस परफॉर्मेंस से क्योंकि आपको हमारे देश में तभी सब रिकॉग्निशन मिलता है जब कोई एक वर्ल्ड स्टेज में धमाका होता है हाँ इससे बढ़िया धमाका और कुछ नहीं हो सकता वुमेन्स क्रिकेट के लिए
हाँ बहुत ही एक बार लाइक ऐसे बहुत सा सैड सा माहौल हुआ सब रो रहे थे लेकिन बाद में लाइक हम लोगों ने एक स्मॉल सा मीटिंग रखा था जिसमें सर ने सब ने थोड़ा थोड़ा कंट्रीब्यूट करा थोड़ा थोड़ा एक दूसरे को मोटिवेट करा और बाद में सर ने बोला अभी वापस रूम पे जाके कोई नहीं रोएगा हम लोग यहाँ पर पहुंचे हम लोग अभी नंबर 2 है वर्ल्ड में और इसको सेलिब्रेट करेंगे बिकॉज इस साल तो
सेलिब्रेट करा आपने
हाँ हम सबने लाइक अच्छे से बात करी सबने लाइक तक जो टीम ने एज ए यूनिट खेला है और एक साथ परफॉर्म करा है आई रियली प्राउड माई टीम कि इतना अच्छा से हम लोगों ने क्रिकेट खेला और बहुत 2-3 महीने जो क्रिकेट खेली है वो अभी तक की मेरी इंडिया की तरफ से बेस्ट परफॉर्मेंस रही है और बेस्ट मोमेंट रहा है
यही गर्ल्स पेरेंट्स के लिए मैसेज है कि अपने गर्ल्स को सपोर्ट करें ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा आगे किसी भी स्पोर्ट में जाने के लिए बिकॉज डेफिनेटली हम लोग अगर आज यहाँ पे है तो हमें हमारे घर वालों ने सपोर्ट किया है
We have a fantastic panel that joins us here today. Also very privileged to be joined by Mitali Raj's father, Dorai Raj. Dilip Cherian is with me here in the studios. Charu Sharma, the well-known cricket commentator with us. Julan Goswami's first coach. Shubhra Rudra joins us, as does Sharda Ugra. I'd like to thank all of you very much for being with us. And we have a small panel of fans of Indian cricket with us as well here in Delhi. I'd like to thank you for being with us as well. But first, let me go across to Dorai Raj, Mitali Raj's father. Thanks, sir, very much for being with us. It's a day of incredible happiness at one level. India's done so well in the tournament. But also, sir, you'd agree that it's a fairly sad day. We really should have won this match. How are you and your family dealing with this reality, the joy of having done well in the tournament, but the sadness of not having won?
Actually, when they left India, I felt if they are reaching semi-finals, that it will be an achievement.
Right.
But the way they progressed during the league phase, then automatically we started expecting more and more. And by the time they reached final, it was really very high expectation was there. That small thing is definitely... I feel bad, but their achievement is great.
But sir, let me ask you this. Do you think we should have scored more singles in the match quicker to try and ensure that there was less pressure towards the end of the innings?
Yes, yes. That I agree. Because we can see from the game 193 for 3 onwards, we were always comfortable. Till the end, we were comfortable that strike rate or run rate was in our hands only. But maybe the nerves, the youngsters who came later stage, the collapse of 7 wickets turned the match. And from then, the opponents, they are very good and they are experienced more than our youngsters.
Okay.
So I think that must have clicked in their favor.
Okay.
Otherwise, we have given almost till the last over, it was in our favor. And I was always, almost I was thinking that we are going to achieve it. But then it's sports, winning and losing is part of the game.
Right.
But almost I feel they have won the hearts of the people and their performance was extremely good. and I hope the women's cricket
does well. Base, okay, all right, sir. I'm going to come back to you. I'm going to come back to you in just a few moments from now, sir. Do be with us. I want to go across to Charu Sharma. Charu, what a match it was yesterday. And in as much as we celebrate India's women cricketers, and there's so much to celebrate over there, aren't you also, as a cricket fanatic, disappointed? How on earth could we have lost this match?
Yeah, it was riveting stuff, Vishnu. And of course, I'm a very long-term follower of women's cricket and certainly Indian cricket. Friends of mine from college have also been the chief of the Women's Cricket Association, the erstwhile body that used to look after cricket. But, you know, yesterday, yes, heartbreak and disappointment. But in the world of sport, Vishnu, and I don't mean to in any way pontificate, you know, there are wins and there are losses. And one is never disappointed, really, or sad after a loss, except the nature of the loss. If you're thrashed by the opposition, you have to be disappointed. And if you lose from a winning position, as the Indians did yesterday, you have to be disappointed. So in that sense, yes, I mean, no praise high enough for the way they played the World Cup, the way they reached the final by beating Australia in a fantastic performance. But in the final, having it in your hands, being able to touch it, feel it, smell it, and then you lose it from there. Well, there was some inexperience. And I think one very important point that you made, which I think Mr. Raj also agreed to, you know, the team, what is next now? Because from every loss you learn. And next, really, every time the ball was, you know, batted back to the bowler or into the covers or to that one lone fielder at mid-wicket, I was left feeling, why couldn't we just learn how to turn the bat a little? I don't want to make it sound too easy, but get that single.
Yep.
Because that's how we were eventually strangled and the girls, got under pressure later
on. A question for anybody over here, do raise your hand. Do you guys think that, you know, this was a match we really should have won, that perhaps it was in being unable to take singles early on that we put too much pressure on ourselves? Would anybody like to say anything on this? Raise your hand. Yeah, go ahead.
Actually, sir, it was like good achievement for the India. And our girls, they played well. And actually, you cannot imagine that pressure during the playing game. So it was very high. Everyone played for winning, not for loss. So they tried good
hard,
and a lot, and like government should also give motivation to them.
But so I think I take your point about pressure, and let me just put that to Sharda. It was really it was pressure at one level. I mean, if you look at Harmanpreet, who scored that insane innings in the semi-finals, it just seemed she was, and you know, I don't know if this analogy is correct, but as a cricket fan myself, it seems like when Yuvraj Singh gets stuck, you know, and he's just stuck with his A game, which is like hitting the ball out of the stadium. And when he's looking around and poking around for singles and is unable to get it, then he's stuck and India loses. And it seemed to me that she was stuck in that same Yuvraj Singh sort of way. She produced the occasional massive shot, but she couldn't get the singles. And was that really the issue, that she seems to have an A game, but there isn't another game which goes with that?
I think Vishnu, we are being a bit tough on Harman. There were lots of other players there as well. A lot of errors that were made at one point, you know, which is, call it experience, call it pressure, call it whatever. That's the name of the game. That's how it goes. We must also remember that the England women's team plays far more cricket than the Indian girls normally do. You know, they get far more game time. How much of sort of pressure situations do you get to play? That's also important, and that showed in the game in the final yesterday. It was heartbreaking, but I was fine with, you know, with happened. The result was fair. I thought England really sort of withstood the pressure that the Indian batsmen had put on them. The bowlers had put first by restricting the total. It was a gettable total. And the fact that they came close, I thought England turned in a very good high-pressure performance, and the Indians were not able to do that.
Okay. Dilip, look, I mean, it's pretty easy to criticize the team. The fact of the matter is the match has been lost. We lost the finals. We've done extremely well. From a marketing standpoint, where do these young women now stand vis-a-vis where they stood about a month back when this tournament began?
You know, Vishnu, as somebody who is enthused about the way this is going, mm-hmm. there are three things to keep in mind. The first is that the big thing for the girls is that many of them have become popular names, and that's great for them. because that means that people are going to look at it, sponsorships are going to consider women's cricket as something seriously worth backing. The second thing is a bit more of a harsh reality. Essentially, everybody loves a winner. So either you win or you lose. And this is a game. They lost. So having got this far is great, but going to the next level is what would have actually made sure that they did the, they experienced the inflection point of great success. And the third thing is, I think everyone's mentioning this, and you could see that in the game yesterday, inexperience. So they need a lot more of outings, as it were. And to do that, this is a great opportunity for somebody like the BCCI to step up, not wait for sponsorships, but actually hike the rates at which these players are playing. So it makes it worthwhile for them to be in tournament mode a lot more of the time. That mode is very important, because that is clearly what was missing in our team yesterday.
Okay. Shubhra Rudra, the first coach of Jholan, from the Rising Star Sports Academy. It's wonderful to have you on the program. Shubhra ji, ye bataye, Jholan ka bowling kal, shayad Jholan hamare liye start thi kal. Aur jo 3 wicket unhone liya, un 3 wicket lene ke baad hi England ko restrict kiya gaya. To kal, aap bataye, Jholan ka performance kitna important tha India ke overall performance ke liye?
Jholan ka to pura responsibility tha ke bowling, uska jo bowling ka jo ye tha, wo to kar liya. फील्डिंग भी बहुत अच्छा किया, एक अच्छा कैच लिया, लेकिन बैटिंग में थोड़ा मिस्टेक हो गया, तो इसलिए तो इसको कप भी हाथ से निकल गया। झूलन रहने से मैच निकल जा सकता है।
आप एक चीज बताइए, आपने झूलन का टैलेंट शायद स्पॉट किया होगा, तो वो हमेशा बॉलर बनना चाहती थी?
हाँ हाँ, वो हमेशा बॉलर ही बनना चाहती थी।
तो आपने ये टैलेंट स्पॉट कैसे किया, मतलब क्या टैलेंट था, हार्ड वर्क अच्छा था, क्या था इनमें, टेक्निक था?
वो बहुत हार्ड वर्क का था, बहुत हार्ड वर्क का था, क्योंकि वो उसका प्रैक्टिस करने का इतना शौक था कि हम लोग छोड़ देने से कि वो सैर को बोलता था कि मुझे और कैच दो और फील्डिंग कराओ, कभी वो थकता नहीं था।
और अभी भी नहीं थकती वो, बस शी जस्ट कीप्स रनिंग थ्रू एंड थ्रू। पर एक चीज बताइए शुभ्रा जी, उनका जो एक्यूरेसी है, झूलन गोस्वामी का जो एक्यूरेसी है, शायद वो उनका बॉलिंग का डिफाइनिंग फीचर है। एक मार्क पे वो हमेशा बॉल करती रहती है, तो ये स्किल उनको कैसे मिला, जस्ट थ्रू हार्ड वर्क, या ये टैलेंट है, या बहुत प्रैक्टिस करने के बाद?
उसका हार्डवर्क और बहुत प्रैक्टिस करते थे वो,
और ओवर द इयर्स शुभ्रा जी उनका पेस जो है थोड़ा कम हुआ है
बॉलिंग करने का।
कुछ साल पहले शुभ्रा जी, कुछ साल पहले उनका पेस शायद ज्यादा था, पर ये पेस कम होने के बाद उनके और कोई स्किल्स आए हैं कट बॉल को कट करने या ज्यादा स्विंग करने में?
उसका तो ज्यादा स्विंग करने से विकेट मिलता था, उसका पेस और स्विंग दोनों एक साथ में होता था, थोड़ा पेस कम होने से स्विंग उसको बहुत कम में आ गया।
चारू, यू वुड हैव वॉच्ड अ लॉट ऑफ दीज क्रिकेटर्स, वी स्पोकन अबाउट हरमनप्रीत, वी स्पोकन अबाउट Jholan, who's really worked tirelessly for the team. She's still one of the finest bowlers in the world in women's cricket. Who are some of the others that really sort of, who you found interesting as talents going forward?
Yeah, you know, the couple of centuries that Smriti Mandana scored, I mean, she is so fluent outside off. Yes, she got done in by a terrific ball by Shrubsole early on in the final, but she is so fluent and graceful outside the off, wonderful lefty, and she's still young enough, so we expect much more from her. Poonam Raut, I mean, she's 4 foot nothing, and the way she plays the game was so refreshing, and yesterday too, she almost took the team to victory. So to have somebody that small, that assured, she's got a long way. Deepthi Sharma, he's only 19 or 20 now, so with her bowling and her all-round performance, she almost took India to victory yesterday. These are just three or four names who've done very well. I know you might want to act Ekta Bisht and a couple of others who took those fifers, but it's not so much in the bowling department. I think the batting is coming good, and so too a bit of the fielding. The running between the wickets has a lot to go. You know, there was a program done a short while back, or some other program that I was enrolled with, where a young voice of a young girl said something very telling, Vishnu, which I might want to quickly repeat here. Little girl said, you know, I like watching women's cricket because the girls are playing almost like the boys. And I think it was a very telling statement, which obviously meant no disrespect. It just meant the fact that the women are playing a lot harder. I mean, Harman and a couple of others hit the ball so well. Vedha Krishnamurthy hits the ball fabulously. What was missing in women's cricket in, say, and again, I mean no disrespect, earlier on in the 70s, 80s, perhaps even the 90s, were the big hits. Now, once the big hits have come, the game has become more attractive. And those who can hit the ball a long way with all their fitness and strength are making a big difference to the team. The diving around on the boundary line and elsewhere, I mean, that was missing earlier on, but that's a joy to see. And of course, the diving, which Mithali did not unfortunately do yesterday, while taking a run to protect the fact that you don't want to get run out, is also wonderfully refreshing to see in the women's game. So these are great changes. I just think the Indians need to be a little fitter, a little stronger. And as you mentioned, point number one, can't keep dead batting the ball back. You've got to find ways to, easier said than done, to move the ball around and get the singles. There was only one fielder at mid-wicket in the 30-yard circle, and every time the ball was on middle and leg, the ball got patted to the mid-wicket fielder, almost every time, which was like, ah, it was so frustrating. But there are some wonderful names, great talent, and yeah. I just hope this carries on, despite the fact that they didn't win the World Cup. More on that later. Okay.